Calvary greeting to everybody and every viewer looking at me right now. My name is Apostle Peter Daniel from Nigeria. This is Heaven and Hell Live Program. Heaven and Hell Live Program. Heaven and Hell Live Program. It is a wonderful thing to have you here looking at me from anywhere you are looking at me. And I appreciate God that God is able to preserve your life and giving you the grace to see this program. By the special grace of God, we used to have the Heaven and Hell Live program every day, 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. to 9 a.m. To 10 p.m. And we used to have a deliverance hour, 9 p.m. to 10 or 11 p.m. By the special grace of God, you are watching me in Heaven and Hell Live program. And once again, my name is Apostle Peter Daniel. If you have any question or you want to invite me to your church or you want to invite me to your country or you want to give your life to Jesus or you want to sponsor this program or you want to pay your tithe and offering to this program, you can kindly call me or WhatsApp me on +2 348 138 966 287. I will come again, +2 348 139 66 287. That is my number. That's my hotline number. I will answer you there by God's grace. Without taking of our time, I want us to pray as we listen to deep revelation of the Lord God Almighty that He has for us this morning. Let's pray. Father, Father, as the Father, the rock of each Israel. We are saying thank you because you never leave us. We are saying thank you because you never abandon us. We are saying thank you because you are always faithful to us. Be glorified, be exalted in Jesus' name. Our Father and our God, we commit today into your able care. We ask you, God, to take perfect control of the world in Jesus' name. Speak to us, open our brain, open our sight, open our mentality, open our spiritual mind in Jesus' name. Thank you because you have answered our prayer in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. So happy to pray that prayer with you. I know the Lord is going to be with you in Jesus' name. And without wasting our time, what is the topic for today? The topic or the message we want to give today is called changing of name. Changing of name. Changing of name. I know you will be like, what does it mean to change of name? There is a secret and a revelation of heaven that you did not know, which I have to tell you today. You see, before your name can be written in the book of life, there are going to be amendment. Not only that, in the life we have now, names matter. This message is a straight message. Name and mad is manners. The name you bear on earth can affect you both on earth and in heaven. So there is a need of a change of ownership, a change of names. Let me say, there are some times ago when I grew up, I used to bear my father, my great grandfather's name, which is called Apara. So that's the same name my father is bearing. That is the same name my grandfather is also bearing. So it's like it's a family name, Apara, Apara, Apara. My grandfather happens to be a prophet, a very powerful prophet in the days of the times of Ayodele Apostle Joseph Ayodele Babalola, who has died, a mighty soul and revivalist in Africa. My grandfather happened to be one of the prophets who are working with him. They used to go to revival together, very powerful prophet. But there's something that happens in those days, which when I grew up, I have to ask my parents about it. This prophet, which happens to me, my grandfather, I was told that the power of God in his life was so powerful that he didn't need to pray before demon bowed down to him. If he's going on the road and a madman see him, a violent madman see him, when they see him like this, even from far, they will bow down to their feet. They will go on their feet and bow down like this until he passed by. That is how much God has empowered this man. The power of God was so much in his life that if somebody is a witch, you cannot come near him. The power of God is so much in this life of this man that there's no how you can say you have a demon inside you. When you see this man, this is my grandfather, coming from far, from anywhere, you will have to bow down. They will go on their knee. This man is also a wish destroyer in his time. He got to a time that sometimes he can decide to wake up in the morning and we just go to a city, because in those days, wishes and wizards are so much in those days. So much in those days. So we just with his bell. With his bell, he has a bell. He has different kind of bell. So we just go there. We start ringing the bell and start commanding with fire. And all the wishes will begin to fall and begin to confess like that. They will come out from all their angles. With the power of God, we bring them out. And they will begin to confess. This man of God was so powerful that in his house, somebody built a house for him. So in his house, there is a place he created for madman. So all the madman in Ekiti State, I'm from Ekiti in Efalaye. So all the madman in Efalaye from different states, from everywhere, all violent one, not just ordinary madman, violent one, critical one, madman like the kind of madman like the legion one, the legion that Jesus Christ cast out. But I mean the violent people, violent madman. That we said that we bring them to this Baba. This is my grandfather. So there might be violence like 3, 4, 5, 6 men can be holding them before. But by the time they get to my grandfather's house, my grandfather will just say, keep quiet. And the man will just, he will be shaking. And I said, take him inside there. And they will take the madman inside there. They will just take the madman inside there. And when they take him inside there, they will see him. They are madman that they are so powerful that when they see him, he will break the chain. So he will heal all of them. They will take them off. All the madman that came into inside there, he will heal them. And they will take them off. Pregnant women that have delay of children, childbearing, there's a room for them. They will bring them, he will pray for them, they get healing and they go. They give birth and they go. He was a miracle man in his own time, but there is a problem in his life. Listen to me very well. This man of God, my grandfather, my own grandfather, my father's father, I as powerful as he is a poor man. As powerful as he is a very poor man. Very, very, very poor man. He died very old age. He was 120 years, he was still jogging. He never bent, he never used glasses, he never used a stick. The Spirit of God was so filled his life that he did not see. He was a strong man. He will be rocking, he will be jogging, he will be running 120 years. He will be running whenever he's hurrying, he will be jogging. And he said, God bless you, God bless you. He was a literate man, but you know, the way he used to talk is somehow different from the way, you know, people talk. But at least he had some little English he used to say. But he's a very poor man. He was able to do his ministry. He died in Christ. And according to people who said that he's in heaven, I was told that he's in heaven. But during his time, he gave birth to my father. Most of his children died. My father was the only survivor child. All of his children died, all of them. My father was the only survivor of all his children. And even my father, who was a survivor of his children, is a devil. He was trying to cast out a demon from somebody's life, and that demon came out of that person. And done. They bring my father to him. My grandfather prayed to him. You know, when you are praying, and blood is coming out of that ear, blood begin to come out of that ear. Just pray. Say, you, the spirit of death, get out. Instead of him to come out, blood is coming out. And then my grandfather was so worried. And he prayed to God. Probably God told him that my father is going to be one of the messengers for him in the deaf world. He allowed it to be. Before he died, he laid his hand on my father. And my father received the power of the Holy Ghost, even as a very young age. He did not know. My father was 12 years old when he died. He died in Christ, in make heaven. When my father grew up too, He got converted on his own without knowing, you know, when the power of God was upon you. He got converted, he was going to school for the deaf in the Ibadan. After those moments, he grew up, he became a very serious Christian. At a very young age, when he was in deeper life, after he finished his school, when he was in deeper life, he died, one of his pastors, his own pastor's son died. And all the pastors gathered were praying for that child. The child did not come back to life. My father was a dead man. My father was a deaf, so he did not know what is going on. But he was in the church. He loved reading the Bible. So after that, he decided to just, something just came in. He wanted to urinate. So he would not go out to urinate. He now saw them pray for the child. He now signaled to one of the pastors. He said, Pastor, please, what happened to this child? Then the pastor now said, this boy has been dead for like hours now. They were all sweating. Seriously, they were tired. And he said, please, can I pray for this young boy? And they said, come and pray. If you want to pray, you can pray. They are all tired. They have been praying for hours. And my father prayed a short prayer and lay hands on the child. And the child sneaks and came back to life immediately. A short prayer and the child sneaks and came back to life. And the rumors came and the word came out and go spread all over the church. Not quite long, they give my father an award in the deeper life. And he became one of the best students in deeper life who understand the Bible and the knowledge of the scripture. Immediately, the day they gave him the award, the day the God called him into ministry. When God called him into ministry, I'm telling you this, I'm coming into point concerning him. When God called him into ministry, the Lord used him mightily to heal the madman, to heal many people, you know, the same, just more than his father. But he was a poor man too. He was a very poor man. God used him mightily. He could not even afford to buy a car in his time. He's still alive. And when I heard his story, I'm a young man. My father gave back to me through prayers, because my father does not have a male child. So he asked to pray to God and said, Lord, if you can give me a child, I will name him Peter. And he's going to be a man of God who is going to preach your word. So God had that prayer and gave him me. When I grew up, I look at the situation around. I heard about my grandfather, how he was very poor, though he was a mighty man of God. And I started praying, no, I must not go poor. Even though my father is a poor man, my grandfather is a poor man, I will not go poor. And I started praying, and I got to understand my father come today. One day, he was telling us about his history, and he said something. He said, there was an issue that happened in those days, that there was a man bearing apparel. And the reason why he's bearing apparel was he was a herbalist. Listen to me very well. He was a herbalist. This man is a herbalist. Why are they calling him apparel? It's because there's something we call adi in Yoruba land. Adi is like a traditional, I don't know how I can call it in English. It's like a oil, a traditional this thing like that. The herbalist used to use it. This traditional something is like a dark something like it. It used to smell somehow. So they used to use it to rub their body. Anybody they attack with affliction, they can use it to, when you are using it, that affliction can go. They call it adi in Yoruba land. This, my great-great-grandfather, was a warrior, a herbalist, a very powerful warrior that nobody was able to overcome him. Whenever he goes to the war, he will kill and kill and kill. He was overcoming, you know, he overcome many wars for our state, Ekiti State. Listen to me very well. It's very, very important. This Baba used to use adin to rub his body. Whenever he uses adin to rub his body, come near any power. No power can confront him. Probably the name of Jesus can overcome anyway. But in those days, I mean the power of darkness. Whenever he uses adin to rub his body. So rubbing the body is what they called apara. No, apara means a man who used to rub his body. Apara. A man who used to rub his body is the meaning of apara. That is the name they gave him. And that is the name he bears to die. But when he wanted to die, he make a curse. Listen to me very well. He make a curse that anybody bearing apara, this and this will happen to them. And he died. And this affected even the powerful man of God, my grandfather, even my father. It's very poor. Until one day I said no, I begin to pray. Listen to me very well. I begin to pray and tell God, Lord, things must change in my life. Things must change in my life. Things must change in my life. And God bring my attention to the name changing. And God said, until you change the name Apara, you cannot prosper in life. You just end up like your father. I said, no. And according to prophecy, the prophecy said that I'm going to be the one to carry my family. So in those days, I'm talking about it. So I now decided that, okay, I talked to my father about it. My father said God has been also been talking to him about it. So my father decided that, okay, let's change this thing. Then we change it to Daniel. God told my father, he said to him that we should change to Daniel. Then we change it to Daniel. My dear sisters and brothers, when we change to Daniel, that we change to Daniel Abaya. Are you with me here? That year, we changed that name to Daniel. I said that year. The next month, I buy a car. The next month of that month, I buy a car. No, I don't know how it comes. I just know that that money just came and I buy a car. Later, I sold the car and things began to change around for me. What am I trying to say? Changing of name. In my family, my father was able to do anything, but I was able to do it because the name was changed. Not only that, in heaven, there are names that we never have. I want you to listen to this in your ears. Names that will not enter the book of life. Anything that imitates something like Oshayemi, idolic name, any name that is not in line with God will not enter the book of life. What do you think that make, and let me tell you something, a part of you fulfilling your destiny, because name has to do with your life. Name has to do with your destiny. Name has to do with your destiny. Name has to do with your success. Name has to do with everything God has called you to do on earth. If a name you are bearing is not a godly name, it's not a name that God knows, let me tell you the thing. You will not, there's no way your name will be written there. There is a need of, that is why when you want to go and baptize, they will ask you to choose a name from the Bible. Do you know that? They will say, choose a name. Because a name that is in the Bible, a name that is, you know, that is godly, that is that name that can enter the book of life. Open your Bible to Genesis chapter 17. Genesis chapter 17. Open your Bible. Genesis chapter 17. Yeah. 17. Genesis 17. Genesis chapter 17 is 1-5. When Abraham was 99, listen to my brother and sister, I'm begging you. When Abraham was 99 years, please quote the year, quote that year, 99 years. 99 years old, the Lord appeared to him and said, I am God Almighty. Walk before me faithfully and be blameless. Then I will make my covenant between me and you. And will greatly increase your number. Listen to me very well. Verse 3. Abraham fell face down, and God said to him, as for me, this is my covenant with you. You will be the father of many nations. Verse 5. No longer will you be called Abraham. Your name will be Abraham. For I have made you a father of many nations. Hallelujah. If you look at the year that Abraham was 99 years, that was when God met him and said, "He will be called Abraham." Are you here? He said, your name will be called Abraham. If I will tell you that God has been telling Abraham this promise that he's going to become a father of all nations. He has been saying this for many years. But there's a hindrance to that. He has been saying that for many, many years, but there's a hindrance to that word. Because that name has not yet been changed. And God knows that that name cannot enter the book of life. He can't ever. And that covenant cannot come to pass in his life. So he was 99 years old when God came to him and said, your name will be called Abraham. Who can tell me the year Abraham got a sight? After God told him his name will be called Abraham, that is where God found it worthy to meet him in one-on-one physically with two angels, plus God making three. And that same year when God said his name will be Abraham, God asked him to circumcise himself, and God came into his house that year when he was 99 years old. And God told him, in this time of next year, you shall have a child. And at the age of 100 years, he has a child. So if Abraham's name was not changed to Abraham, probably he will become a barren throughout his life. A barren throughout his life. He will become a barren man throughout his life. And number two, the promises of God will not come to pass in his life. Hallelujah. Now, those who are in heaven now claims that those who go to heaven and God show many areas, especially the places where our house are built, it is written that Abraham, the standard, was the name of the gate to the entrance of the paradise. Abraham was the name written there, Abraham descendants. It's because that name will change. If your name is not changed, you cannot fulfill your destiny. If your name is not changed, you cannot make heaven. Probably, because why I say you cannot make heaven is that if your name is not in the book of life, then tell me how your name will make heaven. How? Tell me how. When the Bible says in the book of good, Revelation chapter 20, verse 15, it said, if any man's name not written in the book of life, he shall be cast into the lake of fire. So there's a need of a change of name. You need to change your name. Your name needs to be changed. You are bearing a name that you do not know the meaning. Hallelujah. No, look at another covenant in the Bible. Open your Bible to the book of Genesis chapter 32. Verses 28. If you look at the life of Jacob, Jacob was a thief from his beginning. I call him a thief because he stole the child he struggled and got the child, the child birth from his brother. He was also a slave. He slavely served the father of his wife for 14 years. Though God wanted to use him to bring into existence the promise of he has made with Abraham, it was through Jacob that it's going to come, that there will be perfection. But his name has not been changed. It was still Jacob. And the meaning of Jacob means a man who is holding, is a hindrance. A hindrance is the meaning of Jacob. So God will look at that name and see that, this name is no good at all. It's not good at all. And even Jacob himself, he knows himself that the name he is bearing is not a good name at all. And one day, God was passing. God was passing. If you look at that, that Genesis chapter 32, verses 22, he said, and God was passing one day, and Jacob saw God in form of man, and he wrestled with him. Jacob wrestled with God. Jacob wrestled with God. He wrestled with God seriously. That God was begging him that, please let me go. Probably the Bible said God. So I will call it angel, because nobody can wrestle with God. But we have to follow the Bible. The Bible says God. He wrestled with God, that God has to tell him, please let me go. Please let me go. And he said, no, I will not let you go until you bless my name, until you change my name. And God said, okay, what is your name? In that verse 28, in that verse 20, let's read 26 from down. Then the man said, I don't want to go far, I just want to read it. Then the man said, let me go, for it is daybreak. But Jacob replied, I will not let you go unless you bless me. Eh? How many of you will talk to God and say that, and say, Lord, I will not let you go unless you bless me? The man asked him, 27, what is your name? What's your name? And Jacob, he answered. He said to the angel, to God, my name is Jacob. Then the man said, your name will no longer be Jacob, but Israel, because you have struggled with God and with woman and have overcome. You see that? Jacob said, 29, Jacob said, please tell me your name. But he replied, why do you ask my name? Then he blessed him there. You see that? That verse 30. So Jacob called the place Peniel. Peniel, saying, it is because I saw God face to face, and yet my life was spared. You see that? He saw God face to face, yet his life was spared. Do you know that the name Jacob later wiped off in the name of generation? People are still bearing Jacob, but it's not a covenant name anymore. So I pity anybody bearing Jacob. Yeah. I pity anybody bearing it. How can you be bearing the name Jesus Christ have changed? If I reject, Jacob is not, the name Jacob is not a good name to bear. If anybody is bearing Jacob, the person should go and try and pray and change his name to Israel. When God, somebody who is bearing Jacob, he knows that that name is a cursed name. That name is not a good name. That is why he said, please change my, he said, bless me, oh God, bless me. And God was able to bless him and change his name from Jacob. Jacob, no wonder. Something just came into my mind now. My old grandfather's name, who I told you that is a prophet, his name is Jacob Oni Akpara. Probably Kaja can even be one of the things that even affect him. Two names at the same time, that's not even good. Not all names you can even bear in the Bible. They are names that you should not be at all. You have to know the meaning of that name first. If you look at the people who are bearing Peter, they will always be one of the people God is using mightily. Because God has created a powerful covenant on them. No wonder when Jesus Christ met me, he said, I have made you a watchman over my house. And he touched my tongue and said, whatsoever you said will come from me. You will not speak of yourself, but you will speak of me. No wonder. No wonder he says so. He said, you will speak of me. So a name matters most. If you look it now, Israel was still unconquerable till today in the history of man. No matter how they face Israel, they can overcome Israel. Never. Because there's a covenant God has made with that name. Even though they committed sin, God is still remembering them in heaven. God is still remembering them in heaven. That is why the Savior has to pass through Israel to come into this existence. He did not pass through any race than Israel. I'm telling you the mystery of me. Eh? Do you know that it is when Sarah was if you look at the Bible very well, you will see that God said many, many, many names. He said many names. And as he changed the names, they were able to fulfill the destiny. And what I want you to know is this. If you see that God changed one particular name from one name, don't bear the name God has forsaken. Do go and bear. If there's nothing wrong with that, God will have changed. With names, God will not have been changing name from Genesis to up to Revelations. Peter's name was a Simon before. And we see here people are still bearing his sin. It's not his sin. When Jesus Christ said, he said, as from today, your name shall no more be, you shall no more be bearing Simon. Your name shall be called Peter. It has a meaning. He said, because on you I will build my church, and the gate of hell will not prevail. And if you look at the meaning of Peter, the meaning of Peter is called rock. They are conquering. Satan, the gate of hell, will always be looking for anybody bearing Peter that is working mightily for God. Satan will always be looking for a way to attack them, but they will not overcome them. Because God has made a covenant with anybody bearing Peter. And that is working for God. And maybe who are working for God, bearing Peter. God has made a powerful covenant with them. That name alone has carried covenant that no gate of hell will prevail. We overcome them. Never. He has given them key to open and to close. If I tell you what a battery in life, you will open your mouth. He has given them the key to open hell, to close hell, to open heaven, to close heaven. They have the key in their hand. Every name has a powerful covenant attached to it. Every name. For example, now, I have seen Peter, Apostle Peter, before. He has came to me before to come and give me a message. Yeah. Name matters most. Name. If you look at Saul and Abraham, Saul, the Apostle Paul, you will see that when Saul gave his life to Jesus, God changed him to Paul. Are you there? God changed his name to Paul. He left himself. There's no need of changing of name. God will not have been placing him. He knows that before these people can make heaven, there's a need of changing of name. Some of you are still Muslim name. Some of you are still bearing your forefather's name. That is an idolic name. Some people will be bearing Osayemi, Oguntuwachi, Oguneke. They'll be bearing all this idolic name. I don't know your own language. My own language is what I'm using to call. Probably your own language might be something different, like idolic names. See, maybe Karish Michael. You don't get it now. You have to find out the meaning of your name. And God correction and pray to break that covenant in your life and be another name. If you want your name to be written in the book of life, or else forget heaven. Forget it. Or else you forget heaven. Or else forget heaven. Your name will change. It is when your name changes that everything, even our Lord Savior, the Bible said, and he is given a name that is above every other name, that in the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. And somebody starts saying that his name is Yeshua Machia. I don't know about that one. What I grew up to see, what I hear from the mouth of my Savior is that he said my name is Jesus. I don't know about Yeshua Machia. When I see Jesus said to me, he said my name is Jesus. He never said my name is Yeshua Machia. He never said me that. He said my name is Jesus. So anybody trying to say that you are calling me a name that is idolic, they are just wasting your time. I know Jesus Christ. His name is Jesus. Go and change your name if you want to make heaven. There's a need of you to change your name, or else you forget heaven and you forget your destiny, because destiny has to do with name. If the name you are bearing is attached to somebody who is a thief before, automatically the spirit of thieves will be looking for you. Let me tell you something. The Lord was talking to me right now. The Lord said to me now, he said, anytime they wanted to give a baby a name, the demon of a name always call. For example, if a name of if they want to give a baby a name, they want to call him maybe Alabi, and the first person bearing Alabi or the person bearing Alabi is a thief, is a ayah killer. The spirit of that thief and ayah killer from the day of that birth will come and enter that baby, and we start working in his life. Please, there is a need of change of ownership, change of name. You belong to God. Your name must be changed. In this point, I'm going to stop the message. In the short message I give, I believe that you understand very well and it has blessed your life. If you know it has blessed your life, kindly subscribe to this channel. You will hear more messages every day. Heaven and Earth is every day, 9 a.m. To 10 a.m. on 11 a.m. every day. And my name is Apostle Peter Daniel from Nigeria. You can subscribe to this channel, like this button, and also support us. We need your support. Support us. And if you want to pay your tithe and offering, you can hire me also on my WhatsApp and so on like that. I pray the Lord will bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. I want to pray for you today. I commit you into the hands of the living God. My Father, I have spoken your word. I pray that this person, this brother, this sister that wanted to go and change he or her name, I pray that you help her or you help him to change it well. You help him and you deliver him from every covenant that might have attached to his destiny or to his life. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray for your deliverance in Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. It is well with you in Jesus' name. Yeah, we are ending the program. Don't forget to like the button and to subscribe to my channel, Apostle Peter Daniel. And if you want to speak to me, you can speak to me at +234 81 389 66 287. God bless you. God bless you. Bye-bye. Thank you. God bless you. Bye-bye. Yeah, we meet in the night in deliverance hour. Bye.